help has been literally flooding in for victims of Tropical Storm Sendong. But after bringing relief to thousands, now comes the pressing need to move them from temporary shelters to suitable and sustainable homes.
Gawad Kalinga is among the groups helping government efforts to relocate Sendong victims in Cagayan de Oro and Iligan. And here to tell us about the reconstruction program, GK Operation Walang Iwanan, is Ms. Isa Cuevas Santos, a member of the Board of Trustees of Gawad Kalinga. Isa, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Maybe you can give us an update. How many houses have you built so far after Sendong?
Well, we're just about to start. We're launching it on January 25. And so far, the work that's been done is really more social preparation because it's a lot of the families are still in evacuation centers.
Yes.
And we're trying to make sure that the homes where and the land where we're going to build on is really safe and secure so that we can prevent any more loss of lives.
So all evacuees will be given new homes or you will just select a few?
Well, our rule with Iligan, because we're working with a local government unit, is they pre-qualify it together with their MSWDO. And after the pre-qualification, we do the social preparation for them. About 5,000 families still remain in evacuation centers. Mm-hmm. But we're also planning on-site because there are a lot of families that live naman in safe areas, pero tinamaan lang. So, parallel plan.
All right, so in Cagayan de Oro City, I've spoken to one of the GK staff. This is like a project, you know, that's close to my heart.
That's correct.
Helping CDO and the proceeds
you
of this.
You were there, thinking, your family's
there. And we saw each other there too in the aftermath of it. But I was talking to Harvey. I know that he's based in Bukidnon. He's with Gawad Kalinga, but he's also overseeing the operations that are happening in CDO. He was telling me that right now, two areas, the one from Xavier University, so that's about 5 hectares, and that's near Lumbia Airport.
Yes, near the
he
airport.
Mentioned another area. Where is this second area?
Well, there are two other properties that we were considering, but for now, we've been speaking with Xavier University, and it looks like most likely that that's where we will go, especially because that land has been cleared by the MGB, because that's our first priority. We want to make sure that these relocation sites are safe. And our experience with GK, thankfully, is we've been doing this for quite a bit since Kalinga Luzon 2004. And since we started reconstruction, there has been zero loss of lives in our relocation site. So we know that
GK
the model
is saying,
works.
Yeah, what GK is saying is that it works when you relocate them, and there was zero loss of lives in those areas. So,
and in fact, our GK sites become evacuation centers temporarily. The families near there that get affected, lumilipat sila, dun sila lumilika sa GK sites. And kasi higher ground yun.
But it doesn't follow that they will live there, or you will construct the houses for them there.
Not necessarily. Okay. So we, in Iligan especially, mostly relocation, even in Cagayan de Oro, because primarily, and that's the whole issue that GK tries to raise. Of course, it's disaster, but it's really about poverty. Kasi kahit hindi sila tinamaan, they were already in vulnerable areas where they're not supposed to be.
Yeah.
And so our whole campaign since we started is rescue, not even reconstruction. Even before the disaster strike, we're already moving families. And whenever we're able to do that, thankfully, talagang the disaster strike and there's no loss of lives.
All right, tell us, give us an idea. For those who have been helping, because I'm in touch with some of these small groups, you know, individuals trying to make a difference, trying to help in their own small way. The first need was water. And then we had the water delivered. Then cooked meals, and then Kohala and all these different organizations went there and delivered the food. It's moved on from there. They say the relief goods are there. What we really need is to move forward and talk about rebuilding.
Yes.
How do they start? How would you suggest? I was talking to Harvey again, and he was telling me it costs about 110,000 pesos for one home.
Each?
This is including not just the home, but also the social
Social preparation.
Yes, exactly, and training and all that takes place. So that and even the kabataang barangay development of that. But if someone's out there and thinking they want to help, but 110,000 is something that they cannot afford to shell out themselves. What are the different ways in which one can help in the rebuilding efforts in these areas, Cagayan de Oro, Iligan, and even some in Dumaguete?
I think the nice thing with, especially government now, is that the response in terms of the finances has been very quick. And in terms of financial resources, meron talaga to do it. Pero what's seriously lacking is really private sector in a consistent way, and that's really the campaign of GK. So our campaign is actually called GK Operation Walang Iwanan, mm-hmm. para hindi siya na pag natapos na yung bagyo and then another one comes, we forget about the Sendong victims, because it's really volunteerism that's key. Eh. When you look at what we need now for evacuation centers, it's really people that the families can speak with. It's really social preparation, kasi they need to understand that it's not a house that they're receiving. We forget sometimes how painful it is to relocate. Ang sakit-sakit noon. And this time, they relocate and wala na yung mga kasama nila sa buhay. So, it's really that ongoing process of volunteering. So, very inspired kami kasi, like on January 25, even people from Luzon are taking a leave from work for a week
to build homes.
To really go there and build homes with us. Talagang when we launched that in December, nag-lodge talaga ng leave, nag-file na ng mga leave yung mga tao.
Just to be there.
Just to be there. And then what's really inspiring for me is, remember yung Ginsaugon, mudslide in Leyte.
Yeah.
Yung mga GK beneficiaries namin doon, nag-ipon sila and they're all coming to Iligan.
To help.
Because they personally want to speak to the families and say, huwag kayong mag-alala, you can rise above this.
From one survivor,
from
to,
one
another.
Survivor to another. And
that's
they speak Bisaya. And to us, that's the biggest sign na, okay, even our beneficiaries aren't beneficiaries anymore.
Bita, importante yun na.
Speaking
Bisaya.
Kasabot ko gamay. But let's
continue. Oh, kasuwerte, obviously.
Let me backtrack a bit. How can a family avail or join or be a beneficiary of Gawad Kalinga? Because not all of them will be accommodated, right?
Well, one for GK, we really screen the poorest of the poor. Kasi yun yung tier ng GK. Eh. There are other groups naman kasi that work and may families na may kakayahan magbayad.
So that's the major requirement.
Yes,
poorest
for GK, it's really the lowest tier that
so,
we serve.
So does this have anything to do with the access card that was given by the DSWD when it was distributing relief goods? Or iba pa rin to? This is
iba pa rin. Kasi the access cards were really for the relief distribution.
Right.
So the first is you have to be... The LGU has to say you're really poorest of the poor. And then for GK, we actually enroll them in a community program kasi pinapaliwanag namin, hindi po ito bahay, hindi kami mga volunteers na nagko-construct ng bahay. What our dream is to build a community with you. So, meron po yung, as in para kang neighborhood association where you actually say, these are the rules, hindi ako iinom, yung mga anak ko, papasok sa school. So, it's really
That's
an
great.
Enrollment
yeah.
program
no, no, no,
into
wait, who determines the poorest of the poor? You or the government?
We start first with the DSWD, yung local DSWD.
Okay.
So they do that first screening. Pero sa GK po kasi may built-in kami na parang screening committee together with the residents. Kasi
right, so you already have
sila
a system.
Mismo alam nila.
Exactly.
Okay,
they'll know
okay.
who the transients are and who are the...
So walang palakasan yun, Lia.
It depoliticizes it. At least si Mayor hindi pwedeng sabihin na puro lang mga tauhan yan ni Mayor or puro lang yan choice ng GK. It's really a multi-sectoral effort, which is what we're promoting kasi... If we just leave it to government, hindi rin pwede eh. And if we fight for transparency, it begs for engagement.
Correct.
So yun lang sinasabi namin.
If,
don't just criticize, but be
do
involved.
Yeah, do
and
something.
Be there.
Assuming, Isa, that I'm qualified. One is qualified. What is the next step? Do you just wait for the volunteers to come over?
There is an organizing process week by week.
Okay.
Kasi yung values formation, tinuturo namin sa kanila. Para paglipat nila dun sa community, naniniwala sila sa same values.
That's right.
And after that, meron rin yung sweat equity, which is the whole model of GK.
What's a sweat equity?
Kasi
you help build your
help
home.
Build. You help build each other's homes.
Not on your home.
Kasi hindi mo naman alam in the beginning kung sino yung mabibigyan eh. Kasi pag alam mo na bahay mo yan, dadagdagan mo ng tatlong hollow block, lalagyan mo ng extra na bintana. Mm-hmm. So everyone just builds together.
Ay, sinasabi pala pare-pareho yung bahay. Mm-hmm. Tapos hindi mo alam kung saan dyan yung sa'yo.
Yes.
And then my model na nga, like alam na ng GK, how much it's gonna cost.
Yes. Because we've been building it for a
while. Is it right? 98,500 for the materials.
For the actual house itself, and then some part for the
organizing.
There's
actually a breakdown.
Yes. And it's all very transparent so that people know. And we want to show that sorry, it's not just a house. That's not what we do.
It's a community.
If you want to just build a house, go to a contractor and have him build your home. But GK is really, and it's not just a community of the beneficiaries. Eh. Kasi we were talking to the mayor nga. We want Iligan to be that community. We want the schools to care for these communities. We want in the long term, kasi mahaba pa.
Yes.
Even if we build their homes, nako, we have to think of their livelihood. We have to make sure their children go to school.
Right.
And that whole process takes a long journey together and requires a genuine relationship with one another.
Okay, tell us, you've been touched, and a lot of people have been touched by the compassion that's been overflowing, mm-hmm. The help that's been pouring mm-hmm. into Cagayan de Oro, Iligan. How does one begin? For example, if you're not going to work with GK because you're, let's say, a family, and you want to do your help, you've got friends who are telling you, here's the money, and we want you to go there and help them. You have a partnership with Xavier University, is that correct?
We have a partnership with Xavier, with right. Corpus Christi, with MSU, and St. Michael's in Iligan have been such a huge help for us.
So how many homes will be built in the 5-hectare area? Just to give us a ballpark figure, an idea, how many more homes need to be built?
Well, in Xavier, they're saying it's in partnership with all the other groups. So right. thankfully, Red Cross is there.
Yes.
Habitat for Humanity is also
yes.
there. So there's this huge humanitarian effort to do it. For GK, we plan to build 200 homes in Cagayan de Oro. In Iligan, by June, we are going to build 1,500, we're sure, because the land is secure, we already have the house plans.
Bakit ang bilis? Parang ang bilis sa Iligan?
Kasi ang una, na-secure namin yung lupa agad together
agad.
With the local government.
Yes.
And that's the biggest part.
Yes.
And then the LGU also committed to do the land dev. Kasi yun yung, a lot of private groups can give 110,000, pero mahal din kasing mag-develop ng lupa
true,
to build
true.
Access roads, ganyan.
Yes.
And mabuti kasi dun sa Iligan, very fast yung response, no? The mayor was able to get land agad. So, all the private sector donations na ang dami-dami talaga, mabilis naming namobilize. In fact, ngayon nga, we're already building the model house, eh. So,
wow, that's great.
When we thought of when we were going to launch, and it's also Feb 25, mm-hmm. so People Power anniversary. Mm-hmm. And for us, ano na, mga 7 years na People Power over Poverty. And so January 25 is our launch date as part of a whole month preparation for
February
25.
How big is the house?
20 square meters.
20 square meters. And will
just
they,
the size of maybe a condominium unit
yeah.
Yeah.
these days.
Are they going to own it eventually, the lot?
It is a, we're still working out the land agreements with the LGU, pero usually for GK, it is a use of rack that's renewable.
What's that?
Parang free use of land. Kasi ang binabantayan po namin is, number one, professional squatters coming
yes.
in.
Yes.
And then number two, we don't want the families na pag magkasakit lang ng konti, pag mahirap ka kasi maliit
ibenta
lang na bagay,
yes.
kailangan mong ibenta.
Yeah.
Eh. But we're training them na in the beginning, wag nyo pong look at the house as an investment in your security.
Hmm.
And anyway, GK Journeys with you, hindi namin, kaya nga siya walang iwanan.
Uh-uh.
So, today, parang all our communities, all 2,000 of them, we continue to journey with them out of poverty. So, kaya hindi rin namin binibigay agad yung mga bahay. For some, na medyo stable na, we're able to work out the ownership. Pero for GK naman kasi, the bottom line is not for you to own a home. The bottom line is for you to have security of tenure and to belong to a community,
to a
that
community.
Will help you move up. In fact, some of our families nga, when they do better, may mga nagsasabi nga na ibigay niyo na lang po yung bahay muna sa iba kasi okay na kami.
So just to be very
wow.
clear, the beneficiaries cannot sell
yes.
the property.
Yes,
or
it's part of our
transfer.
Agreement with them.
What about transfer to a family member?
For transferring, we pwede to next of kin
yeah.
or GK has right of first refusal. So we choose another poor family kasi mm-hmm. wag naman na ibigay natin sa may kaya na. Kasi
yes.
in fairness mm-hmm. then to the donor, the intent of the donor was mm-hmm. to give it to a very poor person. So we always try to honor that intent.
So their capitalia is just the effort to help other people build the
house. It's really sweat equity. And
oh.
we were very clear. But we want to always share with them na binabayaran mo in full yung bahay mo ha. Kasi yung sweat equity, may value talaga
yes,
yun.
Yes,
yung trabaho mo araw-araw. So, oh. it's not a free house. And that's why the model works. Because there's a lot of ownership. And
yes.
nakakatawa kasi, yung sweat equity, hindi naman talaga kami after mabayaran mo eh. It's really a strategy to masanay tayo to do
yeah.
things for one another. So
mm-hmm.
many times, as we've seen, kasi over 9 years, nabayaran mo na yung full sweat equity
mm-hmm.
eh. Pero kahit hindi siya required, our volunteers and the kapitbahayan beneficiaries, they continue to do it. It becomes
bayanihan
the culture.
Bayanihan na kasi, galing na sa puso.
Mm-hmm. It really becomes a culture.
Yeah.
And even nung Christmas, very touched kami kasi even our own beneficiaries, nagpadala ng pera for Iligan and Cagayan at
mm-hmm.
Christmas time.
Mm-hmm.
And these are very, very simple, poor families mm-hmm. na sabi ko nga, parang mapapahiya ka eh, na you don't do enough. Kasi yung 100 pesos sa kanila, to us, isang handbag yun na hindi binili at Christmas time. And it really inspired a whole generation of people na, as in nagtetext sa amin, is, I didn't buy a handbag anymore. Is, we simplified our Christmas party. Is, we let go of the lechon because we realized na the cost of a lechon pala is. So this whole consciousness na, as an individual, may pwede akong gawin even if poverty looks very big and it looks impossible. Pero, simple lang. Sometimes, for some people, the cost of our house is their handbag. And we've had people that said, I want to live this lifestyle of simplicity so that other people can have just enough. And that's the dream of GK.
And that's the thing that was inspiring this whole time during the tragedy. Just really people being compassionate and just going out of themselves, reaching out and helping. So for those who are watching right now and who still want to help, they know that it's the next phase already. It's rebuilding. It's moving forward. What's the thing that's keeping you in Cagayan de Oro again? You need an approval from the Mines and Geosciences Bureau that it's safe. It's a good place. It's not a geohazard area.
I hope so.
And for all the landowners out there, kasi GK really serves poorest of the poor, so we don't buy land, and that helps because it decommercializes the solutions to these issues. And GK has shown na ang dami pong gustong mag-donate. So GK accepts land donations as long as they are safe, ganyan. We also encourage volunteers. There's a lot of families that are still in evacuation centers. For the people that can share, there's always a need. Even if government is there, government solutions alone are not enough. So if you wanna donate, pwede po yun. And then for all the rest, which is really our campaign, hindi lang po kasi yung sendong yung problema. There are so many poor families out there, and in your own areas, GK is in 2,000 communities. If you really want to do something, you can bring it closer to home. And we're still rescuing families, taking them out of danger zone, so that pag dumating po yung bagyo, kung saan man siya tumama, 2,000 people lost their lives. Many of them unnecessary. If we had just done something prior to that.
So this rescue operation of GK is ongoing. We were talking to the Mines and Geosciences Bureau here just a couple of weeks ago, and they said the maps are there. They've already made it available, and they're willing to make it available to everyone. So you've got those maps, and you're slowly
because
doing
we map it against the land donations to make sure now we don't build in unsafe areas. So 2,000 communities, po, wherever you are, if you can't help the victims of Sendong, there are so many other families that we're building for, and they need help just as much.
So for those interested to donate, how do they go about it? How do they get in touch with you?
Or our website is gk1world.com, so you can donate online, or we can send somebody to come and see you.
To pick up the checks.
Please make sure that we issue official receipts, kasi we've heard, unfortunately, some reports, ganyan. So we
pretending,
also want to make sure.
Pretending to be GK.
Pretending to be not just us, many other things. So please make sure that we issue you an official receipt.
Okay, I'm excited about the launch date. January 25. Bayani Challenge. Is this going to happen in Cagayan de Oro City?
It's going to happen
so
in both Cagayan de Oro.
So everyone in CDO.
Pray that we secure
Iligan.
The land na.
Oh,
para
okay.
We can
so
start.
It's not yet sure.
Secure the land for Cagayan de Oro because you've already secured the one in Iligan.
Yes.
You need help from the mayor? Maybe you want to make an appeal?
See, Father Menebre spoke to Mayor Emmanuel already, and I think everyone's trying to help. So it's just, yun yung push and pull of reconstruction kasi everyone's rushing, but you have to make sure the right foundations are in place because you don't want to make the mistake of building 100 homes in a land that will be swept away again. So it's that push and pull. So we're making sure that all the foundational things are in place. But from where we sit, we're very hopeful that it will all get settled. And so January 25, and then February 25, of course, 1 month after, then we'll start to see all these homes coming.
What's happening on January 25, the Bayani Challenge? What's happening at that launch? And people who want to go, or people who are already in CDO and Iligan, but were not affected. But I mean, when you say affected, really, physically almost. Affected, but almost everyone is emotionally affected by what happened, right? So for those who want to go and help on January 25 in both CDO in Iligan, what can they do?
So form a team of 15, or if you can't reach 15 people, let our offices know and we'll patch you in with some other smaller groups. So it's a team of 15 and we're going to start building the homes.
That is so
cool.
So
we're laying it out already. And we call it a Bayani Challenge because it's really a call for heroism. And more than the homes, it's telling the families, we are here for you, we're not going to leave you behind. Wala po tayong iwanan.
Any expertise needed? When you're there for the Bayani Challenge?
Well, we normally teach you naman what to do para hindi naman nakagewang yung wall ng bahay yan. So there's
kaya
a whole construction plan naman.
Kaya natin yun, Alvin.
Kaya
Leah
yun.
Can go live there.
Yeah.
Broadcast from Cagayan de Oro.
That's a good idea.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
We'll
especially since
that.
You feel so personally connected to it.
Mm. That's great.
Good luck.
We wish you all the best. Go.
Thank you so much for having
homes.
Us.
Thank you.
Thanks so much.
Very excited.
Still to come, 9 Eurozone nations are slammed with credit downgrades.
And Pinoy actors get some screen time on the Bourne Legacy shoot. We'll have those stories and more when Dateline Philippines Weekend.